This presentation will talk about identification strategies for recognizing predatory journals. We will discuss some of the practices of predatory journals, discuss strategies to identify predatory journals, share resources for you to evaluate and find journals, and the goal is to empower you with the knowledge and skills to recognize and identify potentially predatory journals. Before we get started, let's talk about some commonly asked questions. Is there an easy way to instantly know if a journal is predatory? No, journals need to be evaluated first. What about using good or bad journal lists? These lists can be unreliable, which we will talk about later. And are there cheat sheets that I can use? There are resources that you can use in evaluating journals, which we will go into later in this presentation. Predatory journals and publishers are entities that prioritize self-interest at the expense of scholarship and are characterized by false or misleading information, deviation from best editorial and publication practices, a lack of transparency, and/or the use of aggressive and indiscriminate solicitation practices. These are some common red flags that you will see with predatory journals. 1. They email you or your colleagues frequently with solicitations. 2. The solicitations contain grammatical or spelling errors. 3. Solicitations use an incorrect title, name, or institutional affiliation when addressing you. 4. They solicit for a journal that is not relevant to your area of expertise. 5. If the journal is soliciting for a specific topic, the topic is not relevant to your area of expertise. 6. They duplicate a legitimate journal site to steal payment information. 7. They use a name very similar to a legitimate journal to create confusion. 8. The journal lists legitimate but unrelated NIH grant numbers so that they appear in PubMed. 9. Articles appear in PubMed, but the journal is not indexed in PubMed. 10. They use a pay-for-publication model. 11. Rapid publication. Very little time is dedicated to the editorial process. There are some things that appear to be red flags, but may not be. For example, newer, legitimate online journals may not be indexed by trusted sources yet or have citation metrics available. Online publishing is rapidly evolving, and the traditional model of publishing may no longer be relevant to legitimate, newer practices. These are some of the things that we recommend for evaluating online journals. 1. Is the journal indexed in a trusted source, like the Directory of Open Access Journals, PubMed, Web of Science, or Scopus? 2. Is the journal's contact information openly available? 3. Is the journal's address legitimate? 4. Does the journal list its editorial board members and their credentials? 5. Does the journal openly and clearly state their publication fees? 6. Does the journal openly and clearly state their publication guidelines? 7. Does the journal have an archiving policy? When you're evaluating journals online, there are some journal indexes from trusted sources that you can use. For example, you can use journals referenced in the NCBI database in PubMed. You can use the Web of Science Journal Index. You can use the Scopus source list. And you can use the Directory of Open Access Journals. Now we're going to look at some steps that you can take when you are evaluating an online journal. You can start by seeing if the journal's contact information is openly available. In this example here, I'm reading the About section in this journal to see if I can locate their contact information. You can also check to see if the journal's headquarter address is legitimate. This might involve using tools like Google Maps. Does the journal list their editorial board members or journal editors? And do these individuals know that they're listed as editors? You can check using their own personal websites or institutional affiliations. Does the journal openly state their publication fees? If they do not, like in this example here, that may be an indicator of predatory practices. Does the journal openly state their publication guidelines? These are necessary for the authors to know what is required for publication in the journal. Does the journal have a policy for archiving publications? For example, if the journal goes under, how can you prove that you were published? Some additional questions that you may want to ask are, what is the journal's reputation generally? What is the journal's reputation in your field? Can you contact an author and speak with them? Do you know anyone who has been published in this journal? And do you recognize any author or editor names? What about predatory journal lists? Can I just use a list of good or bad journals, like Beale's list? Journal lists are created and maintained by individuals who have their own motivations and agendas. Lists of journals don't always have transparent guidelines or a way for journals to contest their inclusion. Legitimate journals can incorrectly be listed on predatory journal lists for a variety of reasons. Predatory journals have also passed sting operations meant to prove that they're not legitimate publishers. Remember, all journals had to start somewhere. The Public Library of Science is one of the biggest online journals now, but it started small. Online publishing allows for new opportunities for publication, and the publishing landscape will continually evolve. We're going to talk about some guides to finding and evaluating publishers. Is there a quick cheat sheet that I can use? There are resources that you can refer to, including Think, Check, Submit. This helps researchers identify trusted journals and publishers for their research. Another tool you can use is Jane, the Journal Author Name Estimator. Jane will compare your document to millions of documents in PubMed to find the best matching journals, author, or articles. You can also use SpyHub, the Scholarly Publishing Information Hub. This was developed by the Center for Knowledge Management at Vanderbilt University Medical Center to identify journals in which to publish your research. You can also use the Directory of Open Access Journals. DOAJ works with editors, publishers, and journal owners to help them understand the value of best practice publishing and standards to apply to their own operations. These are the resources and training materials referred to in this presentation, and we encourage you to check them out. Thank you for learning about predatory publishing with us. And remember, there's multiple ways to get in contact with us at the Health Sciences Library.